What is up, guys? It's Ryan, Ryan and Crystal's Reviews, and I thought I would share what will become a new series of new comic books from New Comic Book Day, which is normally Wednesday. This is Thursday. This was the first chance I got to get my pulls, and you can see we got a nice little stack here. Nothing too crazy. So I got, maybe 10 books here that we're going to talk about. Some of these I've read already, a couple of these I haven't. So the first book we're going to talk about is Heroes Reborn number 4 from Marvel. It's a great little cover. It's got Thanos on the cover, and then Dr. Spectrum, and he's got the Infinity Rings in this one, not the gauntlet, but he's got the rings. So I have read this one. I read it today. It was a good read. This is actually the first time I'm getting back into some new comics, so this is actually the first in this series I've read. So, it's really good. A lot of cosmic beings, the Watchers in this, Rocket, is highly featured in this. So this is going to stay in my pull list. This is a nice little book. If you haven't got this book and you want to get it, then I would suggest it's a good read. It's just a good read. I mean, there's not a whole lot to talk about other than that. I mean, I don't want to spoil anything for anyone that hasn't read it yet. So on to the next book. The next one I picked up, I haven't read this book yet. This is The Last Ronin. So this is a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles book. I believe this is issue 3. Yes, issue 3. Again, I haven't read any of these books, so I'm looking forward to reading this. This is an $8.99 cover price, so it was a little more expensive. But looking forward to reading this. So pretty good book, pretty thick book. So that's good. Looking forward to reading that. And then the next book I've got, I haven't read this book either, is Spawn 318. So, like I said, I haven't read this book yet. And this is Todd McFarlane, of course, and this is the Todd McFarlane cover. And this is going to jump into more of the Spawn verse. So excited to see what that's going to entail, what everything's going to do with that. Like I said, I haven't read this book yet, so I'm looking forward to sitting down and reading that here shortly. The next book I got, this actually isn't a new book this week. This was a book that was new last week. I didn't pick up, but I really liked the cover, and they had one of these left, so I went ahead and got it. This is Legends of the Dark Knight, number 1. I heard a couple good things about this book, so I thought I would try it out and see what I thought. I really like the art on the cover. As you guys will see, I'm a big fan of cover art, so if the cover art's nice, I'll probably end up buying the book. But I haven't read this yet, so looking forward to that. And the next book is Red Sonja 27. This is the Linsner cover. And I actually did read this earlier, and it's a nice read. Typical Red Sonja. It's a solid book. I love Linsner's art. It's one of my favorites. So that was kind of an easy pickup. And then this one, another Linsner book, another Red Sonja book, Invincible Red Sonja number 1. This is back, I think, maybe a month ago. It's a nice cover. Again, just like his art all the way from Dawn all the way to now. He always does really nice covers. So then I do a little top 3 books that I read for this week. Number 3 is Detective Comics 1036. Really like this book. This is the first time getting back into Detective Comics. Really enjoyed this story. Batman is investigating a murder in his neighborhood. The Lady Clayface shows up, the second Lady Clayface, and kind of he's still trying to figure out what's going on. Huntress is in this. She shows up, and they're working the case together. You can kind of see the cuz, and this is the B cover. You see Lady Clayface here in the background. And he's kind of being swallowed by her. It's a really solid cover. That's a $5.99 cover price, so it's a little more expensive. But all in all, it's a really good book. Really enjoyed this book. It's nice to get back into Batman's series again. So, the number two book this week for me is Something is Killing the Children 16. So this is the origin story of how she gets, she kind of gets introduced to the slaughterhouse and goes through that series, that process. It's very early from the point where she sees her parents and her friend be killed, and then she's kind of, she kills the monster. She's kind of rescued by another slaughterhouse member and then taken to that. And that's kind of where it ends. I know that's probably more than what I wanted to say for people who haven't read this yet. But this is a great jumping off point if you haven't been reading this book. I've done some research into this book. This book's really crazy hot right now because of the TV show that they're potentially bringing to Netflix. So, like I said, this book's really hot, and it's a great read. This is a very surprising how much I really like this book. So, and then to go along with that, I did get the variant cover, the B cover, which is a very nice cover. And looking forward to and reading more. And then my number one book for this week was, this was just out of the blue, pun intended, I guess. I grabbed it. I heard a couple people talk about that they thought it'd be good. I thought, oh, I'll try it out. This is Blue Flame number one. And this kind of gave me a little bit of the Watchmen vibes. With him, maybe not, since they have superpowers, his team does, but it just kind of gave me a little bit of Watchmen vibes, which is always nice. This is one of my favorite series. So, you know, he's a HVAC repairman by day, and he is the Blue Flame by night. And they've got a team, and it's kind of that publicity, you know, it kind of shows that behind the scenes of, well, you know, it's not always Bruce Wayne with multi, you know, billion dollars. Of course, you know, in Detective Comics, he's kind of broke now. Semi-broke, I guess. He's in an apartment. He lives in an apartment. But this is kind of neat because then, you know, one of the heroes is kind of footing the bill through her father and her credit cards. And the credit cards are maxed out, so they have discussion about that. And it's them wanting to get pizza. So it was just kind of before the signing or the photo ops and everything. So it was a really cool read, really nice read. And then it kind of starts out with him visiting another planet, and he is, let's just say, captured because he kind of gives in because he knows he can kill all of them, and they're going to put him on trial for humanity and Earth's existence. And then it kind of backtracks to, you know, him getting out of bed and going to his normal job and being the HVAC repairman. He's from Milwaukee and it's snow on the ground. He's got to shovel snow to get his car out. You know, it's really neat. And so, like I said, I got this on a whim. I thought I'll try it out. You know, if I like it, I'll keep getting it. If not, then it's going to go in the miscellaneous bin and be done. But this was actually a really good book, and I'm really looking forward to next month's book. It's by Vault, and it's a $3.99 cover price. But this is definitely my pick of the week. You should go out and get this book, read it. It's a really great read. Those are my top three picks for this week, and what is hoping to become a new series where I kind of talk about the newer stuff, not just do back issues. So these are my three. These are my top three picks. Blue Flame, Something is Killing the Children, Batman, Detective Comics, 1036. It's a great cover. I just love that cover. And